Greetings and welcome everyone to episode 6 of our Starbound playthrough. We're going to try to accomplish some quests today, and it's going to start with working with this teleporter guy over here, knowing that we have what he needs. So let's first take him what he needs. Quest complete. Let's get technical. You brought me the parts. Wonderful. With those, a dash... With these, the dash technology should be ready for action. But there's only one way to be sure. So let's test it out. My dash technology needs to be properly tested before I can go into mass production. Would you mind putting it through its paces on my obstacle course? Talk to me again when you're ready, and I can send you there. Oh, this sounds interesting. Wonder if we're gonna die here. Let's find out. Let's talk to him. We're ready. Boom! We're off to the obstacle course. Oh, here we are. What do we gotta do? This obstacle course requires that you use the dash technology you have been given to use it double tap A or D to quickly dash left or right. Oh, wow, look at that. So we're gonna stand here and dash. Oh, okay, I get it now. There we go, we made it. Nice. Haha, we're winning. These doors have been very limited timer. It's laughable that you intend to prevail through such frustration. Uh-oh. So there we go. I guess we got through there. Oh, man. This is not easy. We're having to be tricky about it here. How do we get through this door? Uh-oh, what did we miss? Oh, we gotta get through all those doors and back through quickly enough. Oh no, we gotta do it again! Oh man, this is gonna be crazy. This is quite the obstacle course. Whoops. Oh, I gotta do it again! I had the right idea the first time. Looks like we're gonna have to keep trying until we get it right here. Whoops. Oh man. Oh, I keep getting stuck here again. I'm gonna have to go to the edge of it and try it again here. Oh, we did it! What could lie ahead? I wonder. What is going on here? I'm like sparkling. Oh! Oh, I didn't even get a chance to read it. So I gotta dash through there, I guess? While I'm stuck with this thing, I can't dash! Oh, this is terribly hard here. There we go, we got it. We got it. Let's keep going here. Oh no! We got hit by it. Did we make it? Oh, we just missed it! We gotta go back and do this again. It's not that hard. I think we got it this time. This is a little bit easier than that last one. But we're gonna have to try and keep trying here. There we go. That one was faster. That was a lot faster. Let's see. Back to the orbital outpost. Let's go. I think we did it. I think we finally beat that obstacle course. And I think we have a new skill to boot. So let's go up here and let's talk to the professor. We managed to get through his obstacle course with only a slight bit of a headache. The dash tech appears to be functioning perfectly. Wonderful. Please keep the tech as a token of my thanks. I also have other prototypes that need to be tested, so come and see me again when you're ready. Oh, very nice. Oh, very nice. Let's see, who else has a quest here? Let's go talk to the bear. Let's go talk to the bear over here. Let's see what he's got for us. My little dipper lost his dear teddy bear. I just can't finish setting up ship with him like this. Can you help me get a new teddy bear for him? We'll accept this quest. The thing about this quest is, right, I have the ability to craft this silly teddy bear, but it requires a lot of stuff. Let's go look at what it takes to craft this silly teddy bear. I don't know that I have all that's required, but we're going to certainly try to get what is needed for him. So cotton is going to be the biggest issue right now for us here. Let's see. So here we are at the wheel to tell us what it's going to take to make this teddy bear. We need 20 woven fabric and 3 cotton wool. We need one more cotton wool, and for that we're going to need a couple more pieces of cotton. We can gather those. Now about these, we need 20 of those. We need 17 more of these. That shouldn't be too big of an issue. It's a lot of woven fabric though. But we'll make this for him, and then we'll be able to have these teddy bear to turn in for this quest. And I wonder what the payout will be for this quest here. Let's start by see if this cotton appears ready, which it is not. So we're gonna take it with us here. Oh shoot, we can't pick it up. We need to get rid of a potato here. So now we should have 2 cotton plants or seeds or whatever for us to use. Yeah, we're out of space in our here anyway. So now let's figure out, I thought we had more than one piece of cotton, but I guess not. So we have to wait for this to grow, or we have to go find cotton somewhere else. Let's go see if they have cotton up at the for sale. Maybe we could buy some. We only need 2 more pieces to be able to make this work. Let's go check the outpost to see if the store has any of what we're looking for here. Because we've almost got it all. We're so close. We're really like 2 pieces of cotton away. Let's see, that's the teleporter chick. Let's see, there's a general store down here for seeds. Maybe she'll have what we need. Okay, so we got some eggs, some fluffy stuff, grass seeds, flower grass seeds, little red ball and a pet house. Let's see, that's all she's got for sale. So she doesn't have any cotton seeds, nor does she have any cotton itself for sale. Oh nice, a chilled refrigerator. I wonder if I could put stuff in there and if it would keep. Let's throw some meat in there. We got plenty of meat here. Throw in 3 pieces. Not that I need any right this second here. So let's go here. Let's see who else has stuff for sale. Oh wait, I thought the guy down... Ooh, I should be careful. That's almost insta-death there. Ooh, there's a trash bag. I can put stuff in there. And a dumpster fire. So there's the penguin there. Let's go down here. Let's see if he sells anything. The bartender. Oh, he just wants me to do a quest. Deadwing the penguin. Help me out, would ya? Business around here has been so great since all my regulars... Or hasn't been so great since all my regulars are running from Deadwing and his gang of crooks. Can you go and defeat Dreadwing for me? Come speak when you're ready. I'll send ya right up to him. Oh my goodness. So it doesn't look like I'm gonna be able to fight him. Or it doesn't look like I'm gonna be able to buy anything from him just yet. But let's keep looking here. We may get lucky while we wait for this silly cotton here. So let's keep going. Maybe there's another store or whatnot around here. Man, having quite the luck with jumping today. There we go. So we got this guy over here who's got furnishings, but I doubt a colony deed. What is that? A place in an enclosed building with at least 1 door and light sources, and someone will move in. What? Whoa, a guide to colony construction. A manual for the colony deed produced by the colony company. Very nice. So it looks like that might be something we can work towards. And there's even a steampunk bed. That is pretty awesome. That is definitely awesome. So let's go out here and let's see. This is coming soon. There isn't really anything in here. It's an easel. It says easel cabinet. What we're looking for, I don't think it's for sale. I think we are going to have to wait on that quest unless this is a store. Is this a store? Okay, so it has flashlights, bandages, medical kits, which heals even more. than a regular medical kit. It's got the AA batteries, it's got liquid fuel, dangerous and volatile substance, siphoned from moons, and used as FTL fuel. Oh, I guess we could buy fuel if we really needed to. And there's woven fabric, synthetic material, eggs, milk, raw bacon, but guess what? No wool. Everything we need except for the wool. There is some humor in that, I guess. I can even buy leather. That's pretty interesting. Okay, so let's get out of here. We need to go do another quest. Should we do that other quest? I do not know. But for the moment, we need a bed, I think. So we're gonna go up and back down. We need a bed real quick. I almost should put a bed in here just to be on the safe side. Because now I'm going to be beaming down to the planet, and I got to run all the way over my bed. So here we are, we've made it. Now let's make this doggone teddy bear. Let's turn in this quest. So we've made our teddy bear. Now let's go back to our hero, and let's turn this bear back in here. Beam me up! That's the way we got to do it, you know. It's the way it makes it simple and easy. And then we just got to use a teleporter right here. Beam to the outpost, and away we go! Now that we've actually got the teddy bear this time, we'll be good to go. Should be able to turn in the quest without any hitches here. Let's go on our way up. All these people want to go up too. So there we go. Boom. Reward. Let's see what we get. So we got a upgrade module. I'm not sure what these... They can be used to upgrade a ship or other useful equipment. Very nice. So, wonder what his store is. Oh, he sells stuff that might actually come in handy. He can even sell us tungsten, which luckily at this time we don't need, but it could come in handy. You never know. You never know. So what I want to do here is I would actually like to go make this tungsten armor. We should have enough for it now. So I think it would be nice to just go make it. And have it ready to go. Excuse me. So that we can have... Start working towards the next step of our adventure here. Because I tried to do the Deathwing. And I got wiped. Like 8 times in a row. I even tried to record for you guys. It was one of the worst experiences ever. I'm just so underpowered in comparison to that quest line. It's not even funny. I lost all my money. I don't even know how many times. It was bad. It was really, really bad. So we'll craft that there, and then let's go over here. And we want to be able to make the tungsten, so we're going to need... Oh, we need cotton. Wool. So we're short a little bit on wool. In fact, we're going to need a little bit from everybody. So what I'm going to do is, I'm going to go get that, or harvest it, or do whatever we have to do, and then I will be back. So I finally got enough. I think we can do this here. Make the last piece of cotton wool. We are good to go. Took me quite a bit. It's been over an hour and a half since I last talked to you guys, trying to get just this cotton. I really could use some more plants. But let's get to making this here. Let's make this new armor. And let's just enjoy it. We got the breastplate. We've got the... Well, I guess you call them greaves, and then the helm. And that'll be all we should need for this little build here. We should be much better suited for this. So let's swap out here. And I got a lot of potatoes while I was at it, too. This is going to be much nicer. Watch our stats go up here. Ponds, ponds, puddle. Wait, we didn't swap this one. There we go. So that makes me a lot stronger, better armored, more health and energy, and I look totally awesome. I can't really complain. I bet you my damage is even increased. Yep, yep. I also made some progress over here, and I think the next thing I'll do is I'm gonna start building a colony over here. I've cleared out a small area, flattened it out so that I can have room for a colony. That's what I've been doing while I've been waiting for that cotton to grow. I just got a little bit more over here to do, and then I think it's time to work on the colony. So let's see how much damage we do against these guys here. Oh, we do 18 instead of 14. Much better. We upped our damage. Now if we could just find a better weapon. This is one of the first weapons we found. But we'll keep it up. Can't quit while we're ahead, right? So Malt's going to look into ways to figure out how to get more money. Because that's one of the things we really need to work on, is getting more money. But we're going to go here and we're going to buy the colony deed or two. And then what we want to do is we need to build a room or use one of our existing rooms to give them, a place. And then I guess you just put the deed up on the wall and you have a colony. So there's a guide here. So we're going to buy two of these. I think we can afford two at our current amount of money. And then we're going to buy the guide to colony. And then we could probably buy a basic lamppost, but not yet. So let's see here. Let's see what we got here. Can we read it? Okay. So we got the guide here. Are you a budding property developer? Do you have a vacant property that could be earning you extra pixels? Don't delay. Become an intergalactic landlord today. That's pretty good. To start a colony, renovate an old disused dwelling or start from scratch. With a new construction, ensure all walls and ceilings are tightly sealed from outside elements with no gaps whatsoever. Install at least one light source and a fully operable door. Nice. Help your colonists to feel at home. It may sound materialistic, but tenants choose their home based on its contents. Stock up on objects that will appeal to your target audience. Stick to a coherent theme and you may be able to attract more favorable clientele. Once the home is furnished throughout, it's time to place that all-important calling deed somewhere inside, available now from your local furniture store, which we just got. For easy troubleshooting, every calling deed is fitted with a full color display that will keep you informed of your tenants' every needs and remind you to collect your rent as soon as it becomes available. Happy tenants become happy friends for life. It's your responsibility as a landlord to protect your tenants from harm. If you choose to assist them with errands, you may be handsomely rewarded. Happy colonizing. Okay, this is going to be fun. I think we're really going to enjoy this. So having that area clear and ready to go is going to be exactly what we need to be able to get going on this. So I think we read the first section. And this is about Terran's Protectorate. The Terran's Protectorate has stood proudly for over 500 years, striving for peace and unity amongst the many people of the universe. We exist to offer aid to the vulnerable and sanctuary to those living in fear. We endeavor to endure, protect, and support all those who seek our help. We are the Terran's Protectorate. Long may we stand. Interesting. I didn't realize we had that guide there. Oh, these are separate guides. Oh, okay. So we basically just read the one that was important to us. And we also have our two deeds now somewhere in our inventory here. Not entirely sure where. Oh, there they are. Colony deeds. We're going to set them aside. A machine that hobbyists, travelers use to record geological information. I found that on the wall. I don't know what it does, but we're going to eventually use it. But I think we should go and work on getting a place ready for tenants. And as we do that, we are going to have a blast, because I got to clear out the rest of that and build a couple rooms and maybe like set up a basic base here, which will be really, really nice. And then I think what I'm going to do is put in those deeds. But for now, this is where we're going to call the episode. You're going to have to tune in next time if you want to see what the base is going to look like and what those tenants are going to be. So until next time, thank you guys again for watching. Please don't forget to like and subscribe, and I'll see you next time.